They're playing basketball
all around the world.
They love their basketball
to the beach.
They're
y'all
playing basketball.
Let's go. All around the world. Y'all know this is so.
The beginning of the season is always so exciting, like September. You know, we have our, I think of September because that's the first day of, even the night before classes start is our first team meeting. You know, everybody's a little nervous, no one's really talking, and even I'm a little nervous to see, like, are they all gonna gel, how's it gonna work? So that's kind of like how it starts, and then we can't have any interaction with them. So there's 6 weeks of captain's practices where they're working out together as a group, and we're not with them. So we have no idea, we just know what they tell us.
Those first 6 weeks are really just about development and like teaching the new players what it's like to be in college. Not really like getting on them, but like more like getting to know each and every player and like what they're capable of, how it is like playing with each other on the court. Like we play pickup and that's when you learn like what players like if they like to take a jump shot, they like going to the basket. Like during preseason it's more like how can we prepare them to be ready for when it's time to go like and perform in front of coach. When you come in and you're just like, oh, like preseason without coaches, like it's like, oh, okay, so we're fine. And then that last 2 weeks before you get to October 15th and you got to play in front of coach, you get nervous.
October 15th, we start practice. And the first day, everyone's nervous. I mean, it's crazy. Like even the returners are nervous, you know? Even the players that are, you know, there's like this excitement and this nervousness in the air because you don't really know. And you have no idea for the next 4 weeks.
We knew it was going to be tough going into this year, just being that we had so many underclassmen. And just like it takes time to kind of catch them up onto things that everyone else is kind of familiar with.
At first, you know, you see it's a small bench and you just know that, you know, there's going to be more pressure and it's going to be a tougher situation at practice because there's not as many people and stuff, but I think that ended up being a big positive for us.
We had a lot of challenges. The season wasn't without challenges, but it wasn't culture challenges. It wasn't people challenges. It was low numbers and injuries. It was challenges because we had 8 players in practice. And that's really tough, that's really difficult. We played our first tournament at Ithaca and it was a disaster of a trip. My team will tell you everything that could have gone wrong went wrong. I've never had a trip like that in my entire coaching career and that's how we start our season. So we have all these new players. We're super young, and the bus breaks down, and then the bus breaks down again, and then we have to Uber to our first game, all in separate Ubers, and we lose, which we haven't lost in a long time, and nothing looked good, nothing felt good, and I think we were all like, oh, no. Like, this is gonna be a disaster.
How long after Ithaca was it that you guys started, like, getting in your career?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't remember when it happened. It was slow. It was a progression. You know, we lost 4 games, and I can't tell you when they were. I know that we lost at Stockton, because we don't ever win at Stockton for whatever reason.
I think one thing I always will remember from this particular season was we went down to Stockton to do the road game and ended up losing that game. And we didn't do the women's game that day. We did the men's game, but we watched the women's game from right behind the bench. And I can never forget how Sean was, his mind was blown by it in a good way. But we've talked about it a lot, right? And it was that they were struggling and they needed a 3 late to tie. And she said, I know what we're doing wrong and I know how to fix it. And she just got the whiteboard out. And I know for you, that was like a seminal moment this year.
It was just like wear and tears, like little injuries, like Katie Hughes tearing her ACL and everyone had bumps and bruises, like having a 10-player roster is tough, but like we found a way to make it work and that was something that was hard, but most teams wouldn't know what to do in that situation. I felt like we handled it very well.
I don't think that we ever thought that we couldn't make it as far as we did this year. Like, I definitely don't think we overachieved. I think that it might have just taken us longer to get to the point where we needed to be than past years.
Yeah, it was a bit of a roller coaster of a season, up and down in terms of the level of play you were going to get out of this team, but when they needed the big moments and when they went on a 17-game win streak, I think they turned some heads and surprised and just continued to play their brand of basketball.
We couldn't have asked for four better freshmen. You know, they were all so excited to be at Montclair State. You know, that's what you want when you recruit, and I've done this for a long time. So when you have a recruit that is genuinely, like, thrilled to come to Montclair State and to be part of the Montclair State women's basketball program, that's what you want. And these four were like that.
After our freshman year, that was like the big question, like, what are you guys going to do without, like, your senior class? What are you guys going to do without your senior class? And at the time, like, it was us who need to step up and, like, lead the program. And now it's them, and it's, like, really exciting to see, like, what they're going to do with it. And they're going to, like, be great, I think. I think they have learned so much from their years here.
I think Taylor Brown comes to mind, a player that's ready to go into that next role. I think her game seems a lot like Kate Tobey's, and I think that the two of them work well together. I think they learned a lot from one another. I'm really excited for Taylor's next step, for Taylor Brown to take over next year and to see what we can get.
We knew we were going to be a good team and that it just was going to take time to gel. And once we got towards the end of the season, like, we were there. So it was in the moment and it was fun.
I think that end of the season game with TCNJ in particular, you and I did that game together. We went down
bleachers.
There, made the trip right. We did the game from the last row of the bleachers at TCNJ, which was interesting, sitting right in amongst the fans. We've done that before. It was a lot of fun. But that game, I think, did a lot to turn that team into need to be in playoff mode right here, right now. They needed to win out to clinch the top seed in the conference for the playoffs. So I think that game was, I don't want to say wake-up call, but I think it just put them in the right mindset going into postseason play. And I would say, as well, the holiday tournament. They played a couple tough teams from out of conference that came here for just, kind of an invitational midseason. And it was a taste of NCAA tournament play, which was something I think we weren't sure how they'd handle. They had senior leadership, but they didn't have depth with experience in the tournament. And they played great in the round of 64 and 32.
We just know, like, when we step on the court, like, we really have to hold up the Montclair State basketball name.
Especially this year, you could see all the chemistry. We're all very similar. All great work ethic, all, like, a drive toward a win. We all share the same common goal that, we know what our expectations are, and we want to reach that every year, and we don't want to settle.
The crowd's positive energy filled the Panzer Athletic Center as the Montclair State women's basketball team won their third straight New Jersey Athletic Conference Championship. This game brought the Red Hawks' winning streak to 12 games while they clinched their championship title.
It hasn't hit me, I mean, three NJAC championships in a row is pretty amazing. I'm just really proud of my team. I'm really proud of their efforts. They followed the game plan and, it was really great.
We came out and we were ready to go. Like, this whole day we've been planning just to come out and do us, basically.
I mean, we're very happy right now. 3 years in a row, there's no better feeling.
We've just worked so hard, and I think that we really deserve this.
We really, you need to know that everything that we have is good enough if you don't know that, right? And you need to do what you do. Like, Taylor, you don't have to be anyone different today. You just be the person that you've been all season long, right? So everyone just needs to do their job. You don't have to be extraordinary. You just need to be yourself, right? And then we need to do that together, all 14 of us working together, right? Whatever challenge, there's going to be some ups and downs, right? There's going to be some challenges. So we just need to take it possession by possession, all right? We'll be ready for whatever they throw at us, and that's what we do best. Okay? And we'll break through. We'll get our run, whether it's early or late or whenever it is, but we'll have our run and we'll be ready when it happens, right? Mm-hmm. Okay? Team effort, 40 minutes. All right, let's go. Red Hawks on three. 1, 2, 3.
Red Hawks.
Let's go.
Let's get it started in here.
You try to position yourself to win a conference championship, and then you try to position yourself also to get an at-large bid to the NCAA tournament. When the regional rankings came out and we were first in the region, I was like, first in the region, and we looked good on paper. You know? So when the rest of the country thinks you look good, then you start to think, all right, you know? The first point was when we played everyone in the conference, and you're like, all right, so we've played everyone now, and we know we can beat everyone that we've just played. Whether we won the game or didn't win the game, we know we can beat them all.
We did it. Like, our class finally did it. We got our NJAC championship. So, like, every other class, like, they got the chance to say that. So for us to finally get a chance to say that with everything, that every obstacle that we had hurdled and everything that went on throughout the season, like, it just felt special than anything else.
One of, like, the defining moments of the season was, like, the NJAC championship game. And just for us, that's kind of hard to say because we already won three, but this year was just so different, probably because we were seniors and it was our last one, but just I think because like we worked so hard to get there, and like TCNJ is a really good team, so like it could have went either way, and it was really exciting, and just like that feeling was just so different from the other 4 years, so that was definitely a really defining moment. If our season ended there, like I would have been happy with that.
This one, it just felt like there was more pressure because it's our last one and you want to, you know, get all four. But that game, I mean, every game was just so fun, but this year was just like really special because I felt like we just totally had control, you know, being the seniors on the team. And yeah, it was just like, it's just so awesome.
I just remember like the last, like when Taylor was shooting the free throws, like, and we kind of like clinched the game and it was like over.
I couldn't wait to like hug everybody and just like finally like say that we completed what we wanted to do. So I don't know. That moment is still like, it's just so funny and like it's just crazy to me that like it happened. But like when you just think back on it, like we were just all so happy. And that was like, if that was it, then I would have been happy with that.
We extend a welcome to these next two teams, Montclair State and Old Western.
So we're hosting.
Montclair State has the right to play at home after winning a sixth straight NJAC title with the help of the league's player of the year, Katie Sire. Five block shots in the Red Hawks' last outing. Old Westbury enters the field with a record 23-3 and is fresh off a win over top-seeded Mount St. Mary's in the Skyline Conference Championship.
Montclair State, the perennial host at this point in time, they continue to win NJAC titles and dominate the Atlantic region. Six NJAC titles, fifth straight chance to host the opening weekend, but they've struggled a little bit of late in the last few years of getting out of that weekend. We'll see if they can use the home cooking.
So we will see what tonight's action has in store for us. Glad you made us a part of your evening. Hopefully you're all safe inside in the inclement weather here in the New Jersey area and wherever
well
you may be listening. We're just about set to get underway. Pretty good crowd on hand despite the rough conditions outside. Toby and Roger will jump it up here. Officials get the ball in the air. In just a second, up in the air, Toby for it, tipped back towards our table, but in the hands of Destiny Marino.
I think we worked really hard to get where we were. And I think that it wasn't luck. I don't think that, you know, I think we earned it. And I think we earned it every day for 6 months.
A lot of names that are synonymous with Montclair State basketball. I think Coach Harvey is amongst that group. Absolutely. For the contributions she's made and the time that she's been here and the successes that we've seen. Yeah, she's definitely within that group.
To the second round of the 2018
NCAA.
You know, we try to prepare for Amherst is the best defensive team I've ever seen, and seeing them on film and seeing them in person, playing against them defensively is two different things. You know, you watch something on film and you get we knew it was going to be really tough. We knew it was really good. It was hard to simulate it in practice as to how good the defense was going to be because of their length. You know, this group had not played an NCAA game on the road except for when they were freshmen at the Final Four.
The Redhawks return to the Van Noort Arena looking for a chance to redeem themselves after yesterday's heartbreaking loss.
Tonight's game is for third place, but it's more than that. MSU's two seniors are hoping to end their career with a win.
It was a little bit of an awakening that game because they were just like so. I remember I was just such like a baby freshman, and they were just like so good. Like they were so big, they were so strong, and I remember like playing against them and just getting like shoved around, mm-hmm. and like they were making all these shots and they were so fast, and mm-hmm. I was like, oh my god, like I was a freshman, so I didn't like get it yet. Mm-hmm. Like
it felt great, you know, just being able to end our senior year in Michigan in the Final Four with a win in front of all our family and friends. You know, it's just a great feeling just to look around, see everyone smiling, you know. It definitely felt very special.
The coaching staff and Harvey, she's someone that's going to be in my life for the rest of my life. So this has just been a great experience, and I'm so happy to be here. And I speak for the team that we're so thankful, and we had so much fun.
I think, like, when we first came in, as freshmen, those first couple days, the three of us really just got along right off the bat. So we were just lucky to, you know, get along so well so early on.
I think that game kind of like gave me an idea of what college basketball is really like. And you know, after that, I was able to know like to expect anything. Like when I play teams, especially when I play a team that's nationally ranked.
And so I think the first half was tough because we were really trying to adjust to how quickly they closed out, how quickly they rotated, how quickly they did a lot of things.
I mean, the first half was just really tough, and it felt like we weren't playing our style of basketball, and we were down a significant amount. So, you know, there was a possibility that it was going to be my last game ever playing. So I just wanted to leave it all out there and really just give everything that I had and have fun.
We also played a phenomenal second half. And that's what you hope for.
I don't think that game would have went that way, like, at all. Like, once we got the jitters out and we knew that we can compete with them, it wasn't an issue for us. But we took too long to gel about for the situation, but I wouldn't take that moment back for the world. Like, it was a great experience, and at the same time, like, you just live and learn, so.
I think we made ourselves into that Sweet 16 team. Really, and they made themselves into that. because of how hard they worked and how much dedication they put in. So I don't think it was luck. I don't think that it was, you know, overachievement. I think that everyone killed themselves to get us the success that we had.
I probably would say it's my favorite season out of all four, just because of the people. And like I said, I think the smaller team really just benefited us and just made it so much more special. So yes, this season was amazing.
Honestly, every day with that team is just something different and something that is kind of unforgettable. Like, we speak to each other every day, like the entire team. Like, we always communicate when we see each other. Like, when you would see your teammates, like other teammates, you're just like, oh, hey, that's it. But no, like when we see each other now, it's like, hey, like, how are you? Like, it's like we haven't seen each other in a month, but we just saw each other a couple hours ago. And like, it's all hugs and just, we just don't want to leave each other. So like, I just feel like every day with this team is like a special one.
Yeah, oh my God, this season was like so much fun. Like the group we had, we talk about it like all the time because like our chemistry with them is like, it was so good this year. We're all so close. Like you would think that like we still don't see each other, and I see them all every day. And if I don't see them, then they text me and they're like, I haven't seen you yet today. Like, what are you doing? This season was like so much fun. It was a great senior year.
I had fun every year.
Yeah.
And I mean, I don't want to get too sentimental, but I wouldn't trade working with this guy for anything. We had the most fun I would say any broadcast team has had here. I don't want to speak for them because I'm not either of the people that did those games, but I think you and I had a blast with this team. With, and you know, we are the WMSC sports team as a group for sports. We, you know, we are at the station every day, you know, working together. Our culture and our being together and being able to work together and fit together every day, that was a ton of fun. And I mean, I've never been a part of something like that prior to this.
So I had fun. I had fun watching the freshmen. I had fun watching these seniors. I mean, I had so much fun. Just seeing what they can do, how far can we push them? You know, how far can we go? How much better can we get? And going from how we felt at that tip-off tournament to how we felt, you know, 5 months later, it's just, I mean, it's why I have this job. It's the best.
I think Karen Harvey she's the best coach I've been around at any level that I've got to cover. Having done high school sports and done, you know, been around other colleges, she's the most impressive coach when it comes to in-game situations, dealing with her team, overcoming adversity. And I think, you know, this year, and this is not a knock or a disrespect at any other team she's had, but I think this, and you and I have talked about this before, I think this is one of the most special ones she's ever won because of depth and injuries and having effectively 9 players in the rotation after Katie Hughes went down, and a lot of freshmen, a lot of inexperience, and just finding a way to get it done, and not just get it done, but what, go 20-2 for the regular season. I mean, that's really getting it done.
They have been, I feel like I've known them. I mean, they've been here for 4 years. They've been covering our team for 4 years. They were there like that big run when we went to the Final Four. I think that's how it all started. So that was their sort of first freshman year, you know? And so I feel like they've kind of grown up with us, almost like the way that I've watched my players for 4 years. You know, now they're like seniors and they're getting ready to graduate, and they were always so professional. Like, I was blown away by how professionally they handled everything. I felt like I was working with ESPN. I felt like they gave us the respect and the professionalism that I hadn't experienced before at Montclair State. And I think that, you know, they made us feel special, and they made the players feel special. And they took an interest in us before anyone else ever had. And, you know, I think that it's a special relationship. You know, I am so grateful for the time and all the energy that they put in.
Coach Harvey has become, like, a really great, like, figure. throughout my 4 years that there's the ups and downs, and I just know that if I'm having a bad day, I can go to Coach Harvey and talk to her about it. Even though I may not like always go talk to her about it, I appreciate like everything she's done for me. Not a lot of people would be there for the things that I have like that I've been through. So I really appreciate what she's done. And, like I could see us like keep a connection later. In life.
Yeah, she's definitely the best players coach that I've ever dealt with. I mean, they just absolutely love her. They do anything for her. They listen to her, and they have reason to. I mean, she's gotten results here, and she's proven that she knows how to work with them, how to get the most out of them. That's all you can ask when you come in. You know, as a Division III player, you want a coach that's going to make you better. And Coach Harvey makes these players better players on the floor as well as off the floor, and it's worked very well dealing with Coach Harvey. It's been a pleasure.
You know, she kind of helps you in, like, everything, which, like, not most people can say. But their coaches, like, she helps us if we have something wrong with housing, if there's something with scheduling, like, if there's something going on in your personal life. Like, she's there and she knows what's going on, and, you know, but I think just her, like, constantly offering her help to you is just, like, makes her players know that she's always there, like, if you need to reach out to her for something. So I think that's kind of special.
I would just say, like, her helping me become a great leader. Sophomore year, we had to really step up, me, Katie, and Taylor. And I think, you know, we had a lot of meetings together, and we just were able to really talk about leadership and how I can bring people along. I think she looked to me to be a leader on the team even before I really realized it, even freshman year. So I think that she just helped me tremendously with that. And, you know, getting used to that.
She taught me a lot. When it comes to in the games, her philosophy, I just really respected. And from defense to offense to the things she puts in play from each and every game, what she expects us to do, it's just so much about more about basketball than you would ever think. Like the littlest thing, like she wants it perfect. And like from learning that from her, like I can take that for later on in life.
I think achieved more this season than I'm not sure anyone thought was possible, you know. And I think it's a tribute to the culture that they created starting back in September. I think it's a tribute to the senior leadership. I think it's a tribute to the freshmen jumping on board from the first minute and just being a part of the culture and doing what they were told. There's a lot of challenges and you know, what we achieve from September to March 15th is, or whenever our last game was, whatever the date was, is, you know, a lot to be proud of. There was one game this season where they had, like, a dance party. And it was great. I was so entertained, and I was laughing the entire time.
Me and Katie have a newfound love for Wingstop.
Yeah, we get that a lot.
Yeah.
We get wings a lot.
Yeah, we love wings, so.
Like, you build that rivalry with tea. Rivalry.
Rivalry.
You get to have rivals with tea.
Rivalry.
You know, just try and keep possession of the ball.
Yeah.
And like, we just ended up throwing it back and forth. It seemed like it was just the three of us, really. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, I just remember like hysterically laughing that whole time.
I knew, you know, day one, even before then, even stepping on this campus, I wanted to be covering sports some way, in particular covering basketball, because I knew this women's program was talented.
Just to have covered them and to have made them proud, to have had us there and to have been there for them every step of the way to do their games was an honor.